Am I wasting my time reporting scam and spam emails? Hi everyone, Leo Notenboom here for askleo.com. Here's a question I got some time ago. You once said that when it comes to email scams, we should just mark it as a scam or spam and move on. But I found websites to report them to and some email addresses to forward them to, and I'd like to think I'm doing some good. Are you saying that I'm wasting my time reporting email scams directly to these organizations? Yeah, yes I am. I don't believe reporting spam to these sites and services is worth the time and effort. I don't see any harm in doing it. I just don't think it helps. Now, I do want to be very clear, however, that a different type of reporting spam is very, very important, and we should all be doing that. Spam is more than an annoyance. It's a battle. For every step you and I and our email providers take to stop or block spam, spammers come up with new tricks and techniques to bypass those steps. As the recipient of a fair amount of spam, perhaps more than most since I have several public email addresses, I see the magnitude of the problem firsthand. You should definitely report spam using the spam, junk, or the equivalent mechanism in your email program or web interface. Particularly for web-based email services, our collective feedback is how the system learns what is and is not spam. Think of it as crowdsourcing. This information is collected and used to tune what the email service looks for when deciding something is spam or whether or not to automatically place it in their spam folder for you. The more you report spam in this manner, the better the spam filter gets. This does nothing to reduce the amount of spam targeting your email address, but the result is that less of it ends up in your inbox, being deflected to your spam folder instead. Keep doing that. Just don't use the spam button to unsubscribe from things you actually asked for. Doing that actually hurts other recipients. The type of spam reporting I feel is useless is that in which you either forward the email to a specific email address or copy-paste the email body or other information into an online submission form. There's nothing wrong in doing so. It will not harm you or cause you to get more spam. It's just not going to help you to get less. I'm fairly convinced that the addresses you listed already get so many reports that whatever you're reporting is just a drop in the ocean. It would be incredibly rare for you to pass along something that hasn't already been submitted. Besides, the nature of spam has changed such that these services simply can't really work reliably. In the past, most spam came from specific servers that were owned by or had been compromised by spammers. These servers sent out millions of spam email messages. That the email came from consistent servers meant it was possible to track them down and, depending on where they were located, shut them down or block them. That's when most of these reporting services came into being. By forwarding spam to them, you were helping identify specific sources of large amounts of spam. The services then tracked down the owner or the owner's ISP and had the spammer shut down. If they couldn't shut them down, then they added the IP address of that server to a blacklist, which other ISPs then used to block that server. Unfortunately, this approach is no longer effective. Why? Botnets. Botnets, created by installing malware on millions of computers worldwide, have replaced individual mail servers for sending spam. Rather than sending 10 million emails from one server, a spammer might now send 100 emails each from 100,000 infected machines. Your machine could be one of them and you might not even realize it. Of course, make sure your security software is up to date and scanning. 100,000 machines is an impractical number of machines to track down. Even if it could be down, tracking them down wouldn't help. Spammers would just use other infected machines to continue to send out spam. As a result, the reporting services you're asking about can't really help. We do hear of botnets occasionally being brought down, but identifying the spam mails doesn't play a role. Instead, the malware that the infected machines in the first place must be tracked down and defended against. Speaking of bots, a relatively new entry in the report spam arena is the ability to forward a copy of spam to a service of some sort that then promises to waste the spammer's time by using a different bot to engage them in fake conversation for as long as possible. It's another waste. It's akin to fighting spam with spam. You're causing the internet to be flooded with even more fake email. You're contributing to the problem. I'm also convinced that the spammers catch on pretty quickly and recognize the bot for what it is, ineffective and easily ignored. Now, before I write off reporting completely, though I do have to add that some agencies may do more than just track down the servers and the IP addresses, for example, the FTC in the United States, the Federal Trade Commission, they may look at the content of the message and see if what's being hawked violates federal law. With enough instances of an issue, I suppose they could go after the merchant. Unfortunately, they may not do much even then. Many, perhaps even most of these scams originate overseas where the FTC has no jurisdiction. The bottom line, depending on the spam and the service, forwarding email spam to these services has only a tiny, tiny chance of helping. I don't bother reporting spam, other than by using the spam or junk buttons in my email program. Reporting individual spams any other way just isn't effective. These agencies get plenty of spam on their own, perhaps even using honeypot email addresses. I know that there are other people who insist on forwarding their spam to these agencies. Honestly, I have better things to do with my time. I choose not to. If reporting it makes you feel better about spam and scams, and if you've got the time, carry on, I suppose. I just don't believe it makes any difference in stopping spam and scam emails from arriving in our inboxes. For updates, for comments, for links related to this topic and more, visit askleo.com/8457. I'm Leo Notenboom, and this is askleo.com. Thanks for watching.